Welcome to TCPIP Basics IPv4 Address Structure. Let's take a look at what the address structure looks like when we break it down. Some of these different topics are things that we covered in the first video, but now we're going to explain what a lot of them mean. First off, we're using IPv4 for the majority of our videos, and that's because that's the way it's covered in the Network Plus test and other tests as well. IPv4, also known as the fourth version of the Internet Protocol, is the core protocol that routes most of the Internet traffic. This is a connectionless protocol, which means that the state of the connection is not preserved. The data is transmitted to the receiver without ensuring that the recipient is available. It has no idea whether that data got there or not. That's what the TCP portion of TCPIP does. IP is basically just the vehicle that gets you there. IPv4 uses 32-bit addressing, which allows a total of 4,294,967,296 addresses, or 2 to the 32nd power. So some addresses are reserved for public, and some are reserved for private uses. These are called octets. An IP address consists of 4 octets, which are separated by a period. This is also known as a dotted decimal notation. Oct meaning 8 is used because the value of the octets is 2 to the 8th power. We're going to show the math on this shortly. So for example, an IP address of 192.168.0.1 could actually be shown as showing all of the zeros and the 00.1s, but we shorten that to make it 0.1. So even though the numbers could max out at 3, we only show 0 and 1 in the last two octets because there's just no need to show those extra zeros. It's just assumed. What do these numbers represent? Well, they represent a value in binary. Binary is either a 1 or a 0. There's nothing else. We're used to using decimal, which is 0 through 9. So scientists converted the binary invention of IP from binary to decimal to make it easier to read. So why is it 0 or 1? Well, that's really simple as well. The answer is so simple, you're going to be forever changed by the meaning. When you turn on your blender, it's either on or off. Your blender works in binary. 1 is on and 0 is off. Many electronic devices have a 1 and a 0 even printed on the switch. You may not have even noticed it before. May not have even noticed that it was binary that you were looking at. Computers are the same thing. They are made up of a whole bunch of on or off switches. In fact, there are billions of them. When you type the letter A, you set in motion hundreds of thousands of tiny little electronic gates that are a series of on and off switches, like a light switch that flips in order for that A to appear on your screen. It happens at almost the speed of light. In the 1950s, many different scientists created their own language for having computers to communicate, and that's also known as a protocol. And that allows their computers to talk to each other. Well, it made things really confusing. Later on, Microsoft, Apple, Novell, and lots of other companies also created their own way of communicating, their own protocols. Finally, the U.S. Department of Defense came up with the perfect protocol, and they paired it with a connection-oriented second protocol, and we call that Transmission Control Protocol, or TCP, over IP. And it was invented for a couple of different reasons. The first were so computers could communicate with each other regardless of the brand and model of the device. And the second was to allow the Department of Defense to launch nuclear missiles at an enemy target using the phone system. By the 1950s, the phone system was so widespread, it was like a spider web. There was no way any group of attacks could take out the entire thing. Scientists came up with the perfect way to launch a nuclear device without anyone being able to block it. Eventually, the Cold War started to subside and the government decided to give away the technology to companies to increase the economy and create a whole new industry. The information age was born on that day. IPv4 addresses are made up of 8 bits. And you can see here in binary what that could look like. All ones, all zeros, or any combination. Let's take a look at the value of 1. So in decimal, dot one, as you can see, is just a dot one. But in binary, there's seven zeros in front of it. Why is that? Let's take a look. Because binary is converted into decimal. Decimal is just for us. Computers actually work in binary. We're used to decimal. So that's why scientists converted it. But instead of adding up things from left to right, we added up things from right to left. So you can see after the last bit, all the way to the right, you see the value is one, and then it doubles every bit to the left. So we have 1, 2, 4, 8, etc. And that's how we can add up what a binary string of numbers is. Now, it doesn't just stop at 128. It keeps doubling all the way to the 32nd bit. It's just easier to stop at the 8th bit for this particular video. So what would happen if you added up all these numbers? Well, they would add up to 255. Why wouldn't it add up to 256? After all, 2 to the 8th power is 256. Well, that's because in binary, the 0 is assumed. We actually go from 0 to 255. That's 256 digits. So when we add in binary, we don't put the 0 in, as you can see here, because it is assumed that you've already accounted for it. And scientists probably thought it would be confusing to not start with 0. And they were, of course, wrong on that part. So we're going to go more into binary in upcoming videos and have more examples so you can try your hand at converting binary to decimal. These types of questions will be on lots of tests at school and certification tests, such as the Network Plus and A Plus exams. And many employers are looking for that kind of skill in potential candidates.